It's Fran, again at the bench, and I have yet another IEE display, which I've only since I did the last one about the Nemo tube, with all those papers from IEE. Since doing that video, I've learned a few things. One is that they used to pronounce it IEEE instead of saying IEE. If you were in the know back in the day, you would say IEEE. So it's an IEEE display, but IEE. If you remember in those documents, there was a page where they were talking about some of the other displays they were selling, including the Biniview, which again, since doing those videos, people say, well, it's actually pronounced Biniview, like binary view, but I call it the Biniview. So there you go. But in that article, they mention status indicator as another IEEE display, and I managed to get a couple of them. Let's take a look. Okay, here we go. I got two of these. These are two IEEE status indicators. This one is new. It's a status indicator, 28 volt lamps. Lamp number 757. It's got its own model number. Trademark of IEEE, or as they said, IEEE. It's been inspected. And so back again, this looks very familiar. It's got the same kind of spring contacts that were in that daylight 7-segment incandescent readout. It's got this FR4 board on the back, and interesting thing, I buzzed this out, but there's no common on this display. Each of the indicators has a completely isolated circuit, so you got the outside of the bulb and the tip contact for each one. So if you wanted to have a common, you'd have to string all of them together to make a common, which is on this used one. This is a pull. It's got no lens on it, but this one, which was hooked up, you could see there that they made their own common by barring all those together and made like one common, and then all these are the various indicators. But with this one, lens is off, so no idea what it indicated. But we can see inside here, you can see the lamps in there. No lenses or anything, it's just basically a lamp for each little cube, and just a long throw, not like a light pipe, but basically just a long throw just to narrow the beam. So the light of the lamp is just sort of shaped by the segment, you know, this square segment, and that just projects onto a diffuse panel to illuminate a very specific message, which we see on the other indicator here. Yeah, you can actually see them here. PTE on, axis active, feed hold. So this doesn't seem very exciting, but I'm going to hook it up because it says a 28 volt lamp. So, all right. Okay. Oh, there we go. Feed stop, and that's red. Okay. It's a red one. I'm going to move it up. Isn't this exciting? I hope you're as riveted as I am. All right, just don't want to get these shorted out. Okay, here we go. Shift active. All right. So that's a yellow lamp on that one. You can probably get the color, but that's a nice golden orange glow. Yep. Okay. Ooh, love the way that the incandescents sort of just fade out. Can't beat that. Okay. There we go. PTE on. It's another sort of yellowish. Oh, love that glow. All right, and these contacts are kind of close together. I'm really trying not to short out my power supply. Okay, What, your power supply doesn't have short protection? No, it's all analog. I just kind of threw it together. It doesn't have any of that fancy stuff in it. Okay. Ooh, Axis Active. All right. Very exciting. Waited a long time to see a status indicator in the flesh. Here we go, last one. Feed hold. That sounds dirty. You got my feed hold. All right, well, okay. There we go. I can see on the back, because it has these springy contacts, you can see the ones that have bulbs and the ones that don't. So I know that these other ones don't have bulbs in them. You can see a little springy contact up there, there, there. All the ones I did, they all have the springy contact up, and these are all down. So they're all empty slots. But, yeah. It's got this, this is obviously the, hold it against the panel. And it's got these adjustment screws in the back, which you adjust, I guess, from the front. Oh, yeah, look at that. Okay. It's actually, I'm glad I got two of these. Because now I can take one apart and not have to, don't have to ruin the perfectly, good one. Ooh, okay. That's die-cast. This is all... That's metal. Die-cast metal. It's got little rubber boots and some springs here. Wow. Loosen up the screw. So that... Yeah. See, if you turn out this piece, it falls into this slot here. And then... Yep. See, that falls away. And now that can come out. Yeah. That's the whole thing. So that goes into the panel. Okay, this is complicated. So this is also die cast. You can see the bulbs in there. Interesting thing, there's a lot in here. This is like, that is a heavy, heavy casting. This is obviously for thermal dissipation because these are all incandescents. But that slides into the panel and then this would slide up to the back of the panel and then you turn these screws to bring that these tabs up and push on that and that holds the whole thing in and then you snap that die casting, this other die casting, in there and then you have this other outer layer, this outer bezel, which I don't have for this one, that snaps on to those springs. There's one of the springs there. So that spring tab holds on to the bezel, which is also metal. Wow. It's a thin little metal bezel. Let's see. Yep. Ooh. I'm being delicate here. Yep. Gotta hand it to IEEE. They spared no expense with the engineering on this stuff. Even something as mundane as a panel indicator. It's all metal. Wow, that is metal. that is stamped metal. Yep, metal. And that's just wow. And then there's another lens on the inside. So that's held on. Okay. Oh, ooh. Ah, this is supposed to have the lens glued to it. This is very interesting. It's a lot more interesting than I thought it'd be. Oh, that comes out as an assembly. Okay. Oh, yeah. Ooh, that's a very interesting fit. It's like goozy. Oh. Ooh. Yep. That's all one assembly. So, oh, damn it. That's an outer panel. It's got a little, a little beveled corner. And that shows there's a little bevel corner there. So this is just a protective cover, and that's a piece of film. That would be, that's film. That's Kodalith. It's a photographic, it's got, silver emulsion on it, and you develop that it's a piece of film. Very common in the old days, the Kodaliths, You know, it's just, it's black and white, very, very dense silver emulsion, so that you can project through them. You know, it'll be completely opaque against projected light. And that's just like a little, just frosted, dim it down a little bit. It's just a little smoked lens. You know, those springs. And those springs go up against the screw heads. Oh, yep, you can see in there. See the empty slots? Yeah. So, very interesting. Ooh, that feels good. It's a very, very, very good fit. Oh, it just... Ah, that's very satisfying. Oh, and I see it's kind of springy because of those springs. I wonder if those springs are just to allow you to help get that out, or if it actually is like an electrical contact. And then that outer bezel, just, oh, that actually just fits in. That's just tension fit. That's amazing. All right, that's it. Whole thing goes together. I want to see if I can take the back off to see what's behind the. Because there's another screw here. Let's see if this comes off. Oh yeah. Ooh. Beauty. Oh yeah. Look at that. That is solid die cast. Oh, look at that. Spare no expense, IEEE. Oh, yeah. That's a beauty shot. Wow. They are GE bulbs. Wow. This one's completely populated. This would have been... It's a shame that there's no lens on this, because this would have been interesting. Some of these bulbs are very dark, and some are not, so this has... This was in service for quite a long time, and some of these bulbs cycled a lot, some of them cycled very little. Some of them look like they have never been turned on, but, alright. It's a GE, it's a 4819, is that 48 or 1819? Looks like 4819. Anyway, yeah, it's your basic bayonet bulb, and, interesting, it's got a very straight slung filament, I guess, you know, because from the front it wouldn't have so much of a hot spot. I don't know, it's pretty sexy. There you go, there's the contact in there. Nice big flat contact, the springs in it. Spare no expense, IEEE. Oh man. Oh. Very, very positive connection. Yeah. Well, that's really something. The IEEE status indicator, a thing of beauty. It really is. Cool. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all of those amazing people down on the Patreon making these videos possible. It's true. It's the only reason I'm doing this is because of the support. All the people down on the Patreon. It allows me to keep the ads at a minimum, not doing the mid-roll ads or the end ads, and they're all skippable and stuff, so you can skip the ad and just go right to the video. The only reason I'm able to do that is because of all the support on Patreon that keeps this channel afloat. So if you like what I do, consider becoming a patron. Just follow the link in the description, and I will thank you personally. It's true. I'm Fran. I'll be back here at the bench real soon. Bye!
for watching. Friend love, it's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again.